Vivian White from the Astronomical Society of the Pacific will be joining us to show us a simple and fun demonstration of how the moon casts its shadow on the Earth.
Hi, everybody. This is Vivian White here, coming to you from the Astronomical Society of the Pacific. And we're here today to talk about the yardstick eclipse. That's this model here, a scale model of the Earth and moon, the scale size and distance. You can absolutely make one of these yourselves. Just use a yardstick, and I use Play-Doh, or a couple of beads, or you can buy them, this nifty little collapsible version from the Astronomical Society of the Pacific. Just go to the Astro Shop.
So what if we took the Earth and shrunk it down to the size of this ball? How big on this scale do you think that the moon would be compared to that 1-inch Earth?
You know, I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I know. It's hard to tell from here because it's so far away, right?
Yeah.
But it turns out that the moon is about a quarter the size, the diameter of the Earth. So you could fit four moons across the Earth if you lined them up in front. So at this scale where the Earth is 1 inch and the moon is a quarter inch, how far apart do you think they would be? When you look up at the moon and you think, oh, it's small or far or...
I don't know. Miles and miles and miles and miles and miles.
Really, really far away. Yeah, exactly. Right. Absolutely. I get that. It turns out you could fit about 30 Earth diameters in between the Earth and the moon.
Oh.
So if you want to clip the moon onto that 3-inch mark there, 30 more after that, you want to hold that side?
Sure.
Where should I clip this guy, I think?
So if it's at the 34?
Yeah, 33. Yeah, because it's from the center to the center.
Okay.
Good call. All right, so now we have a scale model of the Earth and Moon that's to scale size and to scale distance. Let's talk for a second about how the Moon moves. Do you know how the Moon moves?
No.
In comparison to the Earth? So it turns out the Moon goes all the way around the Earth in about 1 month.
Okay.
It takes a month for the moon to go around the Earth. And every so often, things line up just right so that there is an eclipse. Have you ever seen an eclipse before?
I have not.
Never?
No.
Oh, you're in for a treat. So there's an eclipse coming up in August 21st, and it's a solar eclipse. So depending on where you are, it might either be a total solar eclipse or a partial solar eclipse. A solar eclipse is this, when the moon covers up part of the sun from our perspective. So with this, using this model and the regular sun as the sun, how do you think that might line up? So the moon makes a shadow mm-hmm. on the Earth for a solar eclipse, this one here.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to try and see if you can make the moon make a shadow on the Earth? Sometimes it's helpful to look at the shadow on the ground to see how this works. Hey, oh, you're very close. Oh, look, you've got it. Okay,
hey.
Right here, that is a solar eclipse happening on the Earth.
Very cool.
So where would you have to be on Earth to see this?
Daytime?
Yeah, right, exactly. So this is the day side here. The night side is on the other side. So if you're on the nighttime side, you will never see a solar eclipse. But only part of the daytime side sees that eclipse. You can see that that shadow there doesn't cover the entire...
Yeah, it's just a small area.
The path of totality itself is just that tiny dot in the middle. It's only about 60 miles wide in this case in August.
Wow.
Yeah. You can see why it doesn't happen every month that the moon goes around the Earth. It's really hard to line up. Usually the moon is just a bit above or a bit below.
Okay.
The Earth, it doesn't line up exactly in line with the sun.
So you say that the path of totality is the small area.
Yeah.
Will everyone outside of the path of totality see something?
Yeah, everybody outside the path on a pretty wide swath of the U.S. will see a partial eclipse. On the path of totality, a really cool thing happens is that it gets completely dark for just a few minutes.
Okay.
And you will see the sun completely disappear with the moon covering it.
Don't forget to check out our new solar eclipse website and especially our interactive sun science pages at eclipse2017.nso.edu/science. You can find us on Twitter at NatSolarObs or on Facebook at www.facebook.com/National Solar Observatory, and you can find us on Instagram at National Solar Observatory. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so as you can get notifications when new webcasts are posted. See you next month when we'll be discussing space weather, how the sun's activity has a direct impact on our everyday lives, and how we use man-made eclipses to keep an eye on what the sun is doing.